Hello everyone, I'm Sai Kirtana Midigunda, currently pursuing my second year BBA from UBS. Today, I'm here to talk about the impact of industrialization and globalization on ethical and sustainable business practices. As the Atharvana Veda says, Udyanam te purushah na vayanam, meaning, oh man, may you progress but not regress. Yes, indeed, man has progressed by leaps and bounds due to industrialization and the world becoming a global village due to globalization. However, what assumes importance in this dynamic scenario is the fine balancing of ethics and sustainability aspects with success of global business. Now, let me take you through certain terminology before we proceed further.
Business ethics are the moral principles, policies, and values that govern the way businesses and individuals engage in business activities. A business practice that is economically viable, socially responsible, and environmentally friendly is usually regarded as being sustainable.
New horizons of globalization and industrialization have opened doors to several companies across the globe to welcome cross-cultural values, thereby expanding the scope of work ethics globally. The core concept of sustainability has also taken the center stage as businesses have become more environmentally conscious today. To sum up, the integration of ethical and sustainable business practices by organizations have led to the strong and successful presence of multinational corporations that further boost the economies. Rising ocean levels to the extremely fluctuating weather conditions, flash floods to disappearance in species. This is the reality of the era that we are living in.
Now, let's move on to understand the impact of industrialization on global climate change. High CO2 emissions are leading to depletion in ozonosphere. Besides, the release of dust, smoke, and other toxic gases from thermal power plants and other related industries are thereby contaminating the atmosphere. Discharge of untreated industrial effluents from tanneries and textiles are rapidly destroying the aquatic life, besides contaminating potable water, thereby resulting in the ecological imbalance. There have also been several natural calamities caused by industrialization.
Human activities continue to pose a serious threat for environmental health. And so, addressing the issue of global warming continues to be a prime concern for the global community. For a contrast in the areas of study, on one hand, I have selected a developed economy like China, and on the other hand, I have selected an underdeveloped economy like Egypt.
Well, I found it very interesting that both the countries are supposed to be the seats of ancient civilizations with deep-rooted ethical practices with strong cultural overtones. For instance, the Chinese are guided by the Confucian principles that are based on the dual concepts of respect for elders and goal attainment through mere hard work. Whereas the Egyptians, on the other hand, follow a conservative Arab culture with their base in honor and respect for all, and Vasta, a concept that translates into connections for success in business. In short, they value networking and long-term relationships. Another interesting fact that I found, which is in stark contrast in both the cultures, is about the conduct of meetings. The Chinese are traditionally hierarchical as far as their arrivals to the meetings is concerned, whereas the Egyptians respect prior appointments and stick to time schedules. In the lighter vein, I found that both the Chinese and Egyptians favor gift-giving to win business favors. Coming to the sustainability aspect, both the nations share a common vision, that is the Agenda 2030 of the United Nations, as a part of Sustainable Development Goals. China definitely leads the world in being the first ever country to have achieved the SDG goals 10 years in advance, while Egypt is being sincere in its efforts towards attaining sustainability.
To conclude, I would like to say that the industrialization and globalization have thrown a lot of challenges to all of us to deal with. Yes, we do reap the fruits of their positivity, but that makes us all the more responsible to deal with the negative impacts they have on all of us. Preserving the environment and integrating the ethical practices into everyday business are the watchword for today as we expand beyond the national boundaries, facing diverse cultures on one hand and gear up to combat the challenges of environmental concerns on the other. A new world order that balances the best practices of business with trust and integrity, besides prompt and timely addressing of environmental concerns is the need of the hour. According to me, equanimity, inclusiveness, and collective responsibility are the three mantras for a safe and strong future. Thank you.